The cloak of silence over one of the biggest sexual assault scandals in a New Zealand school has finally been lifted. This is how many boys are found to have been abused at Auckland's Dilworth school, 175, and it's believed that number's likely to be higher. An independent inquiry led by Dame Sylvia Cartwright engaged with 681 people to produce its final report. It's found the school suppressed abuse, silenced victims, and enabled the sex criminals. Dilworth was established in the early 1900s to provide an education for underprivileged boys to give them a better future. But instead, many were abused. Offending happened under former headmasters dating back to 1950, the most recent allegation in 2018. In each era of the school's leadership, complaints were made, but nothing changed. Instead, the inquiries found Dilworth's response to sex crimes was driven by a desire to protect its reputation and finances, as Kim Baker-Wilson reports.
The country's richest school, what was supposed to be a safe haven for these boys.
These are the sorts of stories they live with you forever.
Shocking abuse over more than seven decades, kept hidden.
We've called it a cloak of silence, and we've also said there was a strong motivation throughout to protect the reputation of the school.
Their findings span more than 500 pages, a catalogue of failings and injustice and damaged lives.
It's a damning indictment of Dilworth, its management, its practices.
And it's confirmation of what survivors have been saying for years.
The abuse was horrific, horrific abuse.
He was here today to finally and formally hear these words.
The school and board failed to investigate complaints properly or at all. Failed to determine if other students had been abused by the staff member. Failed to report abuse to the police or education authorities.
If you can stomach reading the report, it pretty much describes my Dilworth experience.
And the experience of so many others. The independent inquiry found a kind of sex ring was operating, highlighting several staff members working together to prey on students.
It's a real indictment on the school for allowing that abuse upon abuse to occur.
The abuse stretching from explicit messages to much, much worse.
I went back there recently with a friend who was raped on the altar of the chapel.
Students groomed and abused.
By Dilworth tutors, housemasters, chaplains, teachers, scout volunteers, staff friends.
Over 73 long and painful years.
Well over 20 of these boys have committed suicide. Many have had lifelong issues.
It needs to contact and collaborate with survivors and their representatives to come up with a redress scheme that is fit for purpose for the boys, that is not governed by money.
11 men have been convicted. In early cases, the school fought to suppress its name and often held police at bay. The inquiry finding the school long put itself ahead of its students.
Well, there was a whole systemic way in which the school operated, which had the result that nothing came out. That's certainly the case. Students were silenced. Teachers were allowed to go on and teach elsewhere.
Some even left with glowing references. Many students were punished for raising complaints.
If they hadn't have caned boys that had reported my pedophiles before me, then I wouldn't have been abused.
The inquiries made 19 recommendations, key among them to reform the trust board.
Unless the school works with the abused old boys and moves forward, it's going to be blighted forever by this scandal.
Just don't be by yourself today.
On a day they've waited so long for.
And Kim's with us live now. How's the school responded to the findings, Kim?
Well, the board has had those findings for almost a week. No interviews were given today, but it has released a statement with no thoughts on any of those 19 recommendations that it has been given. But it does make a promise that it will look at this report and its findings and look at them with care and consideration. It says this report has been unsparingly honest. We did ask the inquirers today what they thought their most important recommendation is, and they said it's one centering on a review of the governance of the school. They say that without good leadership here, it will be very hard for this very old school to change the course that it has been on. The people in our story, though, are very clear about what they want to see, and that is for the current board chairperson to go. They say it is time for him to leave. They say it's also time for police to look at charging people who kept up that cloak of silence, who kept this abuse hidden and secret for so many decades. We again asked the inquiries if that is something they think should happen. They told us that is up for others to decide.
Tēnā koe, Kim. Thank you very much for that.